I put all this on record. And today also I put a very important point called economic chastity. How the intention is married to the dana. Dana kanya, yanya purusha. How both of them are married. And how the satya sangalpa is the potency of yanya purusha. All this I put it on record. Actually, that is the reason I made a clear law in Kailasa, the Reserve Bank of Kailasa, and there is going to be one more unit called Federal Reserve of Kailasa, and there is the World Trade, Hindu World Trade Center. All these units, everything will be administered only by the sannyasis who took the oath in front of the fire doing viraja homa. They absolutely, they will live aparigraha, non-possessiveness, asteya, non-stealing, ahimsa, non-violence, satya, truth, brahmacharya, living like God. Only the sannyasis who took these vows in front of fire in viraja homa, they will be the Reserve Bank directors and governors in Kailas. This vows for sannyasis is not just spiritual and social, it will be legal. If they miss in this vows, they cannot be directors of Reserve Bank of Kailasa anymore. The first priority is going to be the bala sons, kids who joined my gurukul as minors and grew up in gurukul, became adults and stayed with the sangha throughout and took sannyas. They will be the first class citizens of Kailasa. They will be called as crown princess and prince. Crown prince, crown princess. The next class will be kids who joined in gurukul as minor, grew up, trained, evolved, but in between, due to their teenage or some reason, they missed some of the vows of sannyas. But decided to do prayaschitta, came back to their integrity. That class, those sannyas will be the second, next level. The third will be adults who joined the sangha. When they came to the sangha, they were adults. So they had training and took these vows and successful sannyas. They will be the third tier. So I am clearly categorizing who are going to be the directors of Reserve Bank of Kailasa, who are authorized to be the directors and members of Federal Reserve of Kailasa, the other units like Hindu World Trade Center, who are going to be administering the wealth donated to Kailasa, because intention and the dana, integrity to the intention and the dana need to be maintained. That is economic chastity. And in all these policies and processes, each country in which we are operating, those countries' laws are the first priority. without violating those laws, following those laws, we need to keep the economic chastity and integrity, the intention of the donor. That is the way the whole Kailasa organizations externally in many countries and internally in Mahakailas is getting structured. I am just giving the Hindu principles and vision. The 6 international companies auditing experience companies. There are 2 companies which is working for us as 100 years expertise in international auditing. So we have taken all their services for legally structuring this whole Reserve Bank of Kailasa and Federal Reserve of Kailasa and Treasury of Kailasa. Understand? Any nation, the important constituent of the nation is treasury. So here the Hindu treasury comes with the Hindu principles of economy, especially this economic chastity. All these principles I share with these companies whom we hired their services, and they are structuring, working with various governments. In some countries, a non-profit organization. In some countries, for-profit organization. In some countries, the organization entity can be partially profit, partially for-profit, partially non-profit. So based on each country's laws, these entities and bodies are formed. Keeping that country's laws, rules, regulations as the first priority, and the Hindu vision, Hindu economic policies as the next priority, but without compromising on the economic chastity. I also made a rule. The government running, governing expenses cannot cross more than 1% of any donation received or money generated. The whole government, governance of Kailasa, has to run within less than 1% of the whole economy, the whole GDP of Kailasa. Only then the sannyasis will retain their Brahminical lifestyle. Understand? In Kailasa, Varna, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra does not come by birth, jati. No. It comes by the quality of your lifestyle. Based on how you exist, how you choose to exist, based on that, you are given the title, whether you are a Brahmana or Vaishya or Kshatriya or Shudra. Not by birth, but by quality. And the sannyasis who are administering, who are the governors, who are directors of the Reserve Bank of Kailasa or Federal Reserve of Kailasa, is expected to have absolute aparigraha and asteya lifestyle, living with minimal things, the minimalistic lifestyle and non-stealing lifestyle.